The China's Environmental Challenges Study Tour gives our environmental engineering and science students a chance to go to China and learn firsthand about some of China's environmental challenges.
We were basically just given an open-ended question: was how can we solve a particular environmental issue in China?
I decided to go to China for the study tour because I thought it was something different and I needed something to do for my science project, which is a core subject for my course.
Assessment involves both individual and group components. So I get the students to do an individual research assessment before they come on the trip. After that, while they're there in China, we get them to actually form groups and start to select a particular challenge.
So the activities were mostly visiting research organisations, not-for-profits, and sort of speaking with different academics who are doing research in different areas.
Yeah, so we explored a range of issues facing water, soil and atmospheric sciences, and then also working with fellow students in environmental science and also across engineering to see how we'd all collaborate and work together towards a common goal.
We took the students to see the South to North Water Transfer Project. We took them out to the Fanco mine in southern China. And we also take them out to the North China Plain, which is one of the main areas where agriculture is practiced in northern China, and looked at some of the new water saving technologies that they're developing there. There's a whole range of activities we get them involved in.
The site visits were really great. They've got a lot of access to some quite sophisticated technology with regards to groundwater, both in the field and on pilot study sites.
So the highlight of the project work was initially going over there with no idea what I wanted my science project to be, and then coming back with a concise answer of what it was, and it was something I'd never even considered, so I thought that was very rewarding.
The highlight for me is really seeing the students go to that next level and start to engage and get involved with the activities that we're doing. I think there was a really high sort of level of value for the time that we spent in China in terms of what we were able to do.
The things we study at uni are really applicable to challenges in other countries. Although the environmental challenges that are posed to the likes of China may seem huge, the stuff we learn really is applicable, and we can at least make a start on making things better.
It was a great opportunity to witness a new culture and a new landscape, and that's always an exciting time. And then also doing that with a group of like-minded people is also something was a very big highlight of mine.
I think the most important thing I learnt from the trip was just that what I've been working towards and what I've been studying is definitely what I want to do. So having the opportunity to see things in practice out in the field just confirmed for me that I've been heading in the right direction, and I really enjoyed it.